السلام عليكم. إن شاء الله this tutorial will be about chapter 15, the chemical reactions. Here we have acetylene gas C2H2. Okay, so C2H2 here is the fuel, okay, and it is gas, okay. So C2, let's increase the font. C2H2 is the fuel, okay, that is needed to be burned with the air, okay, during a complete combustion process, okay, complete combustion process in a steady flow. It is a steady flow process and it is a complete combustion process. What we mean by complete combustion process, that the C2H2, the fuel, will react with air, okay, will react with air, okay, and air we assume that it consists only as an approximation it is approximately two elements, okay, consists of two elements, which are O2, the oxygen, and also 3.76 nitrogen, okay. So the fuel will react with air and it will be burned in a complete combustion process. What we mean by complete combustion process, okay, like complete combustion process, that the whole the whole element, or the carbon, the all the carbons will be burned, okay, with the air, and the results will be only CO2 plus H2O, water, okay, and nitrogen, okay. There will be no products like CO, carbon monoxide, or hydroxide, OH, or carbon only, or H2, or O2, oxygen, okay? All of them will not be included in the products when there is a complete combustion process, okay? So the amount that we need from air in order to burn the whole fuel, okay, the total fuel, or the minimum amount of air that we need, okay, the minimum amount of air needed for the complete combustion of a fuel is called this word, or the theoretical air, okay? Okay, so we call it the theoretical air. So when a fuel is completely burned with a theoretical air, no uncombined oxygen is present in the product gases, so there is no oxygen, okay? And also, we call it 100% theoretical air. So the complete combustion process, we call it 100% theoretical air. Okay. Notice that the products of the theoretical combustion, which is the complete combustion, theoretical combustion, contain no unburned fuel. The fuel is C2H2. So there is no unburned. All of the C2H2 is burned, okay? That means what? That means that you will not find in the products after the arrow, okay? You will not find C, you will not find H2, CO, OH, or O2, okay? Only that what you will find is CO2, H2O, and N2. But this this reaction is not balanced. Yani if you see, for example, the number of moles for carbon, here is C, carbon times 2, okay, number of atoms. So it will be 2C in the reactant, before the arrow, okay? And it is will not equal to the products, which is only 1C, okay? For H2, here we have only one H2, okay, we will take it like this H2, one يعني that is the pure element, one it is all يعني exist like H2 as a يعني molecules together, not only one element, okay, but there is no other element like H alone, so it is only one H2, okay, and here also in the H2O we have one H2, okay, so this one is balanced, the hydrogen is balanced, okay, but for oxygen, let's see the oxygen, here we have only one O2, okay. But in the other side, I have 1O2, okay, plus this one is only O, not O2. There is no number of atoms, يعني, only 1O, okay. So if I say that 1O2, it is 1O2, okay, that means that O is equal to 0.5 O2. يعني it is the if this one contains two atoms, that means that this one is only one atom, so this one is 0.5 O2, okay, so this is 1.5 O2 on the product side, and I have 1 O2 on the reactant side, so it is not equal, okay. The same thing with nitrogen. I have 3.676 nitrogen, and in the on the other side I have N2 only, so I need to balance the reaction, okay, and we said that in the complete combustion process, okay, I have 100 theoretical air. We represent the 100 theoretical air with a coefficient of the for the theoretical air, which we call it ATH, okay, the coefficient for theoretical air, okay. So if I write this reaction again, it will be C2H2 plus O2 plus 3.76 N2, and this will give you CO2 plus H2O plus three plus N2, okay, that's what we wrote the last time, okay, so we didn't balance yet the reaction, okay. So okay, first you need to balance the elements of the fuel, C and hydrogen, okay. Here they always do like this, okay, and here I have C2, okay, that is the first step. I have two atoms for the carbon. I will put also two here, so in order to balance the carbon, okay. And here for the hydrogen, I have also H2, okay. Here H2, so it is balanced. If it was, for example, H8, okay, that means that I need to multiply H2O by 4, okay. So you need first to balance the carbon and the hydrogen, okay. But in this reaction, I only have H2, which is already in the product. I have H2 also. Okay. Now, what we call the combustion process, the complete combustion process, that is 100% theoretical air, and we will use the coefficient ATH for the air. Okay, because I am talking about theoretical air. So I will multiply the air. This term is air. We say that it consists, يعني, approximately from only two elements, oxygen and nitrogen. Okay, so I will put ATH here, and also ATH. I want to balance the oxygen and the nitrogen. The nitrogen also is multiplied by 3.76. Of course, I need to multiply here also by 3.76 and multiply by ATH, okay? So here I will have 3.76 times ATH, okay? Now I need to find the value for ATH. I will use the oxygen in order to measure or to calculate the value for ATH, okay? So here I have for oxygen ATH only, ATH times O2, okay? And this will give me that I have in the other side 2O2 on the product in the product side, okay, plus this one is only O only, okay, so it is one it is like 0.5 يعني if it is if it was O2 it will be 1. So if it is only O, so it is 0.50. So there, this one is 0.502. Okay. Whenever you see O alone, not O2, okay, divide by by 2. Okay, like half is like dividing by 2. Okay, 1 over 2. Okay, so this one will give you that the theoretical air, the ATH, this coefficient, is equal to 2.5. Okay, now I know the theoretical air, and already the equation is balanced, because now, of course, yeah, it is balanced. We balanced C, the carbon, we balanced the hydrogen, and now we balance the oxygen. We'll put here 2.5, so it will be 2.5 times 2, which is 5. And here I have 2 times 2, it is 4, and I have 1 oxygen, so it is also 5. And nitrogen will be the same, 3.76 times 2.5, and here also 2.5 times 3.76, so it is balanced, okay? So let's write the final reaction. It will be C2H2 plus 2.5 O2 plus 3.76 N2, and this will give you 2CO2 plus H2O plus 3.76 times 2.5 nitrogen. Okay, that if you have a complete combustion process. Okay, now let's see question 1553. He said what? He said acetylene gas C2H2 is burned completely, so it is also a complete combustion process. But he mentioned another thing, which is with 20% excess air during a steady flow combustion process. So he added this sentence, 20% excess air. So I can say that in actual combustion processes, okay, in real life, it is common practice to use more air than this really means that let's use the theoretical, instead it's easier to pronounce, theoretical combustion process, complete process, okay? The theoretical complete combustion, okay, that the one that we used here, okay, that in the previous question, okay, to control the temperature, or to control the temperature of the combustion chamber, okay? So usually we use more air, more than the theoretical air. The amount of air which is in excess of the stoichiometric air, or the theoretical amount of air, is called excess air. So I can say that the theoretical air can be expressed as 0% excess air. And if we said in the previous question, we said that the complete combustion process without any excess is 100 theoretical air. Okay, so it is 100% theoretical. I can say also it is equal to 0% excess air, right? Because there was no excess, or there is no more air to we put it to in order to burn the fuel. Okay, now I have in this question 20% excess air. So if I add 20%, this one will be 120% theoretical air. Okay, and this one will be 20% excess air. Okay, I used in the previous question with 100 theoretical air, ATH. Okay, now like it is 1 ATH. Okay, like I divide my 100% 100, and so it will give me 1, which is 1 ATH. Okay, that's what I used here, and I multiplied the air by ATH. It wasn't multiplied by anything, like I multiplied by 1. Okay, now when I added 20%, it is like I divide by 100 also. This will give me 1.2 ATH. Okay, so I will put 1.2 in the previous equation. So I will multiply here by 1.2. I multiply here also by 1.2. Anything that I put ATH or 2.5, I multiply it by 1.2 also. Okay. So that is the difference when he gave you excess air. Okay, the amount of excess air is usually expressed in terms of theoretical air as percent excess air or percent theoretical air. Like 50% excess air is equivalent to 150% theoretical air. 200% excess air means that you added 200 on the 100 theoretical air, so it will be 300% theoretical air. Here we added 20%, so the theoretical air will be 120% theoretical air, okay, which is 20% excess air, okay? That is the meaning of excess air, the additional amount of air added in order to burn the fuel, okay? So if I want to write the reaction again, it will be something like this, C2H2 plus, it was 2.5 times O2 plus 3.76 N2, I will add also times 1.2, okay? And this will give you the product 2CO2 plus H2O plus 3.76 times 2.5 times 1.2 also N2. Okay? Also, what happened when I added excess air, that it was at the beginning 2.5 times O2, right? Okay, I added 0.2 more times 2.5. So at the beginning it was like this. 1 times 2.5, okay, and we said like it is 180H, okay? So 1 times 2.5 times the air. Now what I added is I added 0.2 times 2.5 air, okay? So if I add them, it will give me 1.2. times 2.5, okay? So the additional of air is 0.2 times 2.5 air, okay? I already made a correction for the nitrogen only, for the nitrogen here, okay? I added 1.2 instead of 1. I added the additional 0.2. But for oxygen, I didn't correct this one, so I need also to add oxygen, okay? So I will add oxygen, and it will be times it will be 2.5, okay, times this additional amount 0.2, okay? So the complete process is burnt, okay, and C is burnt totally, okay, there is no C, only I have CO2, I don't have CO or OH or C alone or H2 like this, okay? I only have CO2, H2O, and nitrogen and oxygen. The oxygen, this amount added when there is excess air. That is the only difference from the complete combustion process at the first question and the complete combustion process at the second question, that we added 20% excess air. When you add a 20% excess air, the only thing that is added is O2, the oxygen. Okay? So now let's simplify the reaction. I multiply 1.2 times 2.5 and 0.2 times 2.5 and so on. Okay, it will give you C2H2 plus 3O2 plus 3.76 N2, and this will give you 2CO2 plus H2O. Okay. Plus 11.28 nitrogen plus 0.5 O2. Okay? Nice. Now let's go to the second sentence. The fuel and air enter the combustion chamber at 25 degrees Celsius. So the fuel, C2H2, and air enter the combustion chamber at 25 degrees Celsius. And if he didn't mention anything about the pressure, you will assume it is the atmospheric pressure, okay, which is 1 atm, and it is also in kilopascal, is 101.325 kilopascal, okay. and usually one atmospheric pressure with 25 degrees Celsius, okay, we call them the يعني the reference reference temperature and pressure, okay, and at this temperature, at 25 degrees Celsius, which is 298 Kelvin, we usually calculate H naught bar, okay. So you will use always this value, 298 Kelvin, to calculate H bar naught, okay. From table tables A18, A19, A20, like this, يعني this table tables usually, okay. We will see in the end of this question, inshallah. Okay. And the products leave at 1500 Kelvin. So the products leave at this value. So as you can see, that is the reference temperature. Okay. For us, even if it is not, it is not the reactant temperature or the pressure. يعني if it is, يعني if this one is, for example, is given 7 degrees Celsius, like the slides question, okay, for air, for example, always the reference temperature will remain 298 Kelvin and 25 degrees Celsius. Happened by chance that in this question the inlet or the reactant enter the combustion chamber with the same reference temperature and pressure, okay. So at this one, at this temperature, also I need to find H bar only, and we will see any how we will find them. And after I am talking in general right now, okay. And this one also will be H bar. We'll calculate H bar at 1500 Kelvin for the products, okay. So the temperatures of the inlet and the outlet, or the temperature of the reactant and the products, you can calculate. It will help you to calculate H bar, but the reference temperature, and it is always will be there in the energy balance when we do it, and we will see. يعني inshallah, it will help you to calculate H bar, and you have note also. Okay, it has the reference. That is why we have the superscript note. Okay. Okay. Now let's find the first requirement. He asked determine the air fuel ratio, okay, and I will add more things to be determined, okay. I need to calculate the air fuel ratio, and let's also calculate the fuel air ratio, the opposite. This one is air fuel, this one is fuel air ratio, so we have to be careful when he asked, okay. They are different. That FA, the fuel air ratio, is 1 over air fuel air ratio. So fuel air ratio is equal to 1 over air fuel ratio. And also I want to calculate the dew point temperature, okay. So the air fuel ratio AF is equal to the ratio of the mass of the air, because it is air fuel ratio, so air is first, so it will be in the numerator, or the mass of the fuel, okay. The mass of the air is equal to number of mole of the air times the molar mass of the air, okay. And for the fuel, I have, for the fuel is C2H2, so it contains two things, right, the carbon and the hydrogen. So it will be the number of mole times the molar mass of the carbon plus the number of moles times the molar mass of the hydrogen, okay. This will give you that the number of mole, from where I can find the number of moles in, from the reaction, from the equation, okay. So now I'm talking about air, this term, okay, it is multiplied by 3, and already this I have here 1, and I have here 3.76. the total term is air, which consists of 1 plus 3.76, which is 4.76, okay. 4.76 is already multiplied by 3, so 3 times 4.76, that is the n number of moles for air, okay. Always we'll do like this, okay. So it will be 3 times 4.76 The molar mass for air from table A1, table A1, and I think usually it will be given, or you need to memorize it. Okay, if you don't have table A1, or write it in the question sheet. I don't know if it is allowed. Okay, it will be 28.97 kilogram per kilo mole, I think. Okay, so table A1. Kilogram per kilomole, 28.97. Okay. So times 28.97. Okay. And number of mole for carbon is, يعني it is 2 times 1. Okay. 2 times 1. Okay. You need to take also the atoms. Here already we take the air is already consists of the oxygen as O2 and the nitrogen as N2. Here you need to take 2 times 1. Okay, so that is the number of moles. So it is 2, and the molar mass for carbon you need to memorize it is 12 kilogram per kilo mole, plus number of moles for hydrogen, which is 1, because we take hydrogen as it is like this, so it is multiplied by 1 and it is already H2. Okay, it is already H2. It is like not like C. It consists of 2 molecules. Okay, this one is only 1 atom. Okay, okay, but there is 2 here. But يعني I'm talking about C. It is alone. When I put 2, I need to multiply it by the 1. Okay, but here H2, I take it all of it. Okay, because that is why I wrote here H2. I didn't write C, write H only, like here I wrote C only. Okay, and at the end, يعني, if you wrote H, okay, what will happen? You will say, okay, I will, it will be like the carbon, I have 2 here, so I will also take 2 times 1, it will be also 2, okay? So at the end, it will be the same, because the molar mass of the hydrogen is 2, and already the molecules is 1, يعني the moles is 1, so 1 times the molar mass for this for hydrogen is 2. Okay, and if you want to say, okay, I don't like this, يعني I'm confused, okay, I will take hydrogen and say, okay, there is 1 here and there is 2 here, 2 times 1, it will give you 2, because the hydrogen يعني alone, if you see the يعني I think خلاص يعني it is clear, it's H2, it is 2. Okay, so this one will give you 15.91 kilogram air, okay, in the numerator, over kilogram fuel. Okay, if you want to calculate FA, it is equal to the fuel air ratio, it is 1 over AF, and it is equal to 1 over 15.91. And this will give you 0.06285, the opposite, kilogram fuel over kilogram air. Okay, for the dew point temperature, okay, dew point temperature, it is from the AC chapter, it is the saturation temperature at the vapor pressure. Okay, from where shall I get the vapor pressure? You need to use this equation, that the vapor pressure over the pressure of the products will equal to number of moles of the vapor over number of moles of the product. Okay, if I arrange the equation, it will be PV equal to NV over N product times the pressure of the product. Okay, number of mole of the vapor, what I mean with number of mole of the vapor is the number of moles of the H2O. Okay, so here the number of mole of H2 is 1. Okay, that is H2O. I assume it is gas, because يعني we are talking about 1500 Kelvin to high temperature, so it is a gas. Okay, now I am looking for the number of moles for the vapor, so it is 1. Okay, so this one is 1 over number of moles of the products. All the products I have 2, 1, 11.28 plus 0.5 for CO2, H2O, and nitrogen and oxygen. Okay, so I will write 2 plus 1 plus 11.28 plus 0.5. Okay, times the pressure of the products, which is the atmospheric pressure, but you have to put it in kilopascal because you need to use the vapor pressure as a kilopascal, because you will go to table A5 in order to calculate the saturation temperature, which is the dew point temperature at the vapor pressure. So it is 101.325, that is in kilopascal, which is equal to one atmospheric pressure. Okay, so this will give you 6.856 kilopascal, that is the vapor pressure. Now I will use the equation that dew point temperature is equal to the saturation temperature at 6.856 kilopascal. If you go to the table and you will do interpolation, the answer will be table A5, 38.38 degree Celsius. Okay, I added this these requirements because to cover most of the ideas inshallah. For part B, he asked for the heat transfer for this process. Okay, so in order to calculate the heat transfer for this process, okay, it is usually in the burning or the combustion, usually we have Q out, okay, heat transfer out. It is exothermic reaction, okay, تفاعل طارد للحرارة. Okay, so if you made energy balance on the combustion chamber, okay, it is a steady device, so already delta E system, and he said it is a steady flow process, okay, so it is equal to zero, delta E system, okay, steady flow combustion process, okay, so E in equal to E out. What I have, if you saw the diagram for the combustion chamber, I have E in, what I have the reactants, okay, so the summation of all the reactants will be, usually in the previous chapters we said if I do energy balance, I multiply the mass flow rate times the enthalpy. Here I'm multiplying the number of moles times the enthalpy in per moles, okay, so number of moles in this one will be in kilomole, okay, for the reactant, times the enthalpies, and we need to include the enthalpy of formation, okay, and we will see from which table. Usually it is table table A26, okay, plus the enthalpy of the state that you have here at the reactant. I have the state 25 degrees Celsius, okay, minus the enthalpy of the reference temperature, which is at also the same, by chance it is also 25 degrees Celsius, and we will use the Kelvin 298. Okay, that is for the reactant. That is the only thing in. Okay, for out, I have Q out, and also I have the products. Okay, the summation of the number of moles for the products times the HF, the enthalpy of formation for the products, plus H. And this one, H bar, will be for 1500 Kelvin, okay, minus H naught at the reference temperature 298 Kelvin, okay. If I arrange this equation to calculate Q out, so Q out will be equal to the summation of NR times HF bar naught plus H bar minus H bar naught R minus the summation of the products HF bar plus H bar minus H naught the products. Okay, now what we will do, that we will use tables in order to represent this equation. I will make a table for the reactants and I will make the table from for the products, and I will calculate this term, and I will calculate this term, and then I will subtract them to calculate the Q out, the heat transfer out. Okay, so the table for the reactant. Okay, I have the reactant. Okay, the reactants at the beginning, I have the fuel, right? The fuel. Okay, so where is the final equation? That is the final equation. So I have C2H2. Okay, that is the first thing, C2H2, the fuel. Okay, I have also what? I have the oxygen and the nitrogen. That is the only three things on the reactant side. Okay, so I also have O2. And I have the nitrogen. Okay, and this one, he said in the question, it is gas. Okay, and we'll see. Yani, it will not affect in this question, but if we see the question in the slide, it will affect. You need to know that if it is liquid or gas, because the answer will be different. Because sometimes different fuels have different enthalpies. If the phase is changed, okay, from gas to liquid, or if there is difference in the values, okay, if it depends on the gas, if it is gas or liquid. Okay, number of moles from the equation is 1, okay, 1 kilomole, okay, number of moles is 1, yani it is in kilomole, but yani in general it is in mole, okay. HF note, dash, this one is the enthalpy of formation from table A26, we said. Okay, so I will go to table A26. Okay, for C2H2, acetylene, this one, F note dash, the enthalpy of formation, is this value. Okay, so it will be 226730, and for C2H2 I don't have what is called H prime, H dash, or H dash note, okay, because already these values are calculated from the tables before table 26. Okay, and where is table 26? Is here, okay? In the previous tables before the table 26, you don't have any yani for the fuels, or for yes, for the fuels, you don't have tables to calculate H bar, okay? So it is yani we will assume it is not yani it will not exist, or yani it is zero, okay? So what I will do, I will apply what I am doing by this table, that I am applying this equation, this term, okay? So I need to multiply 1 times H of the formation, enthalpy of formation, so 226730, and the other terms are 0 minus 0, okay? So it will be at the end the same, 226730. The zero. This last term, yani all of these values for enthalpy, H note dash F and H dash and H dash note, these three, okay, the unit for them is kilojoule per kilomole, okay. Here, the answer for H substance, this one is kilomole, okay, yani we will assume that I have kilomole times over kilomole of C2H2. So the value for H substance, this one will be like its unit will be kilojoule per kilomole C2H2. Okay. So that is the value for the last column. That represents the one of the terms inside the summation of the reactants. Now we will see O2. O2. I have the moles, number of moles or kilomoles is 3, okay? So 3 times 1, okay? So 1 O2 n. So it is 3, okay? So 3 and 4, the pure elements like oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon, the enthalpy formation is 0. So always for this you put 0, this one is 0, and this one also is 0. Okay? H prime, H dash, this one will calculate it at the entrance temperature for the reactant, which is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay? But we will put it in Kelvin, so it will be 298 Kelvin. Okay, at 298 Kelvin. And this one also at 298 Kelvin because it is the reference temperature for us, at the reference temperature. Okay, so this will give you, at least by chance, yani, and if you saw the question in the slide, it will be, here it will be for air, it will be 7, which is 7 degrees Celsius, it will be 280 Kelvin, okay? So there will be difference, but in this question, it is like this, it is, yani, easier. Okay, and as you can see, if they are the same, they will cancel each other, right? They will cancel each other. So, no need to write, but yani, because at the end, the answer would be 0000 for O2 and N2. But yani, let's see what how can we get the values for H dash and H dash note. Okay, so I will go to table the oxygen table. Okay, the oxygen table is table A19. Okay, at 298 Kelvin, and I will take this value H dash, and which is also H dash note at this in this case. Okay, so it is 8682, and this one also is 8682. So it will be, if I apply the equation, it will be 3 times 0 plus 8682 minus 8682, and this will give you 0. Okay, the same thing with nitrogen. Nitrogen, the moles for nitrogen is 3 times the 3.73. So 3 times 3.73, it will give you 11.28. It will be the same like the products, yani. Okay? So it is 11.28. Okay? And for nitrogen, it will be the table before the oxygen. This one is table A19. The nitrogen will table 8. It will be table A18. Okay? So it is 2669. 2669 at 298 Kelvin, and this one is also the same. So also it will be 11.28 times 0 plus 2669 minus the same value, so it, at the end it will be 0. Okay, I will add, I will sum this column, okay, and I will write the answer of the summation here, so it will be at the end 2, 6, 7, 3, 0. It will not change. Okay. Now I finished the reactant table. Let's see the products. The products table. Okay. So let's take it. I have in the products. I have CO2. And I have H2O. And I also have nitrogen and oxygen. Okay. For CO2, it is the number of moles is 2. Okay. So this one is 2. And again, usually it is kilomole. Yeah, but in general, anyway, we talk about moles, kilo mole is the unit, yani, as you like. Okay? H dash note, if the enthalpy formation for CO2, always enthalpy formation from table 26. Okay, so carbon dioxide, that is the value for the enthalpy formation, negative 393,520. Okay? So it is negative 393. 520. What else? Okay, and H dash. This one will be now at 1500 Kelvin because that is the outlet temperature for the products. Okay, 1500 Kelvin. And this one is always 298 Kelvin. That is the reference temperature for us. Okay, so I will go to table for CO2. Okay, table CO2 table. This one is. What, which one? CO2 stable A20, okay, at 1500 Kelvin, it is 71,078, okay. So this one is 71078, and for H dash note, this one 298 is 9.364. So this one is 9.64. Okay, now what you will do, that you will apply the equation, this term, okay. So it will be number of moles, which is 2 times 3 and negative 39352 plus 71078 minus 9364, and this will give you negative 663612 kilojoule per kilo mole C2H2 يعني. Okay, يعني I don't care. Negative 663612. Okay, for H2O now. Okay, for H2O, I have the number of moles is 1. Okay, number of moles is 1. This is the first thing. Okay, number of moles is 1. And for the enthalpy of formation, we assume it is H2O, but like a vapor. Okay, because it is a very high temperature, so it is, we assume that I will take this gas, not the liquid. Okay, unless he mentioned in the question. Okay, so I will take this value, not the negative 285,000. Okay, so I'll take negative 241. Okay, so this one will equal negative 241820. And for H bar from the table for H2O is stable 23 at 1500 Kelvin, it is 57999. Okay, so 57999. Okay, and for H note bar, it is 9904. And then I will apply the equation. It will be 1 times negative 241820 plus 57999 minus 9904. Of course, you will do this by calculator, because it will take a lot of time if you write every row. Okay, so this will give you negative 193725. So this is negative 193725. Okay, and now for N2, the number of moles, if you saw the equation or the reaction, it will be 11.28. Okay, the enthalpy formation for nitrogen and oxygen, carbon and hydrogen, we said it is 0. Okay, now the enthalpy H bar for H2, hydrogen is stable, and that is nitrogen is stable A18, I think. Okay, A18 at 1500 Kelvin 47073, and H note bar is 8669, and you will do the same. It will be 11.28 times 0 plus 47073 minus 8669, and this will give you 433197.12. okay, so that is 4.433197.12. And for O2, I have the coefficient, which is 0.5, the axis air, 0.5, okay, and we say the enthalpy formation is 0 for oxygen. Okay, so for H bar, the oxygen is stable A19, 1500 Kelvin, 49292. not here. Okay. 49292 and for this one it will be 2682 and this will give you 20305. If you add this these four values will give you negative 40384.88. okay, now that I want to calculate Q out, I'm doing all of this to calculate Q out. So already I got this value for the reactants and I got this value for the products. I will subtract the reactant minus the product and in order to calculate Q out. So Q out will be 226730 minus, and already I have minus from the products, again the answer is already is minus 40384.88, and this will give that Q out is equal to 630565 kilojoule per kilomole C2H2. Okay, now let's see the question in the slides. Okay, it is incomplete combustion process, not complete. Okay, what is going on here? That you have liquid propane, and he said liquid. Okay, now if it is liquid, the problem that when you want to calculate in the table the enthalpy of formation for the liquid here, and you will go to table A26 for propane, this one, you will not find the liquid, you will find only the gas. Okay, so what you need to do is to take this value, okay, for the gas, the propane, okay, and subtract from this one the molar mass of the propane times the enthalpy of vaporization. Okay, these two values you can find them in table 27. Okay, so here I have the propane as liquid L. Okay, at this row I can find the enthalpy of vaporization, this one, and also I can find the molar mass. I will multiply 44.097 times 335, and I will subtract them from the enthalpy formation of the propane also for C3H8, but for the gas, in order to calculate C3H for the liquid. Okay, that is the way to calculate when you have something not again, you don't have the enthalpy of formation for something in or for a substance in table 26. Okay, and you have the other phase, the gas or the yani the other phase. Okay, so that is what he did here, and that is the difference from our question. Also one of the differences that here air is at 7 degrees Celsius, at our question in the whiteboard is at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, here it is at 7 degrees Celsius. So you can see that at the reactants we didn't put zero here as the whiteboard. We'll have values. Okay, also in this question he said what he said, at a rate 0.05 kilogram per minute. So he gave you the rate, the mass flow rate of the liquid propane when it enters the combustion chamber. Okay, and you will use this one to calculate the mass flow rate of air, because you already can calculate the air fuel ratio, right? From like what we did in the question in the whiteboard. Okay, and I will multiply it by the mass flow rate of the fuel that is given in the question. What will happen is that the kilogram of the fuel will go as kilogram of the fuel, and you will have kilogram air per minute. This value you can take it and multiply it by the Q out that you will obtain from the subtracting the final answer from the two tables for the reactant and the products, and then this will give you you multiply m dot times q out, and this will give you q out. Okay, like what he did that the value for the heat from the table is يعني it will be 863,880 kilojoule heat is transferred from the combustion chamber for each kilomole of the propane. Okay, the propane the propane the value for the molar mass is 44. Okay, so what he did that this answer is already in kilojoule per kilomole. Okay, and he decided to divide by the molar mass. Okay, so I will divide by the molar mass. The unit for the molar mass is kilogram, right? It's kilogram per kilomole. So now the answer will be kilojoule per kilogram. This answer, okay, which is 270, here divided by the kilojoule or kilomole, the molar mass of what of the propane, which is C3H8, okay, will give you this one. This one is Q out, small, kilojoule per kilogram. He multiplied the mass flow rate of the fuel in order to get this one. So where did he use the molar mass or the mass flow rate only for the mass flow rate of the air? يعني it was asked from him. Determine the mass flow rate. Oh, okay. If this only was asked from him, خلاص that is يعني that is the way to find it. يعني the air fuel ratio times the molar the mass flow rate of the fuel, and you can use the mass flow rate of the fuel given the question in order to calculate the يعني the rate of heat transfer out in kilowatt. Okay, and that is a unit that we use in يعني that we are familiar with. يعني not we you don't usually use per kilomole. Okay. Also, the difference in this question, that is what he said also here, that it is mixed with and burned with 50% excess air, so ATH will be 1.5, okay, because 50% excess air means that 150% theoretical air, okay, and air that enters the combustion chamber at 7 degrees Celsius, we say that the temperature now is يعني different from the reference temperature. And analysis of the combustion gases reveals that all the hydrogen in the fuel burns to H2O, but only 90% of the carbon burns to CO2, with the remaining 10% from HCO. So that is the meaning that it is not complete reaction, it is not complete combustion, it is incomplete combustion. Okay, so whenever you have CO, OH or carbon alone, H2, O2 alone, means that there is something, يعني not the theoretical air, يعني not the complete assumption, because you will add either you have excess air like the question in the whiteboard, or you will have incomplete combustion in the carbon already. يعني the carbon, not all the carbon will be burned. Okay, some of them will be some of it will be a product which is CO. Okay, carbon monoxide. Whenever you have this, he will do the same like what we did to calculate ATH. Then the problem now is in order to find يعني in order to يعني how to will do it, let's do it together. Okay, he found ATH which is equal to 5. Okay, so he will put يعني for example this one is 5 and this one is 5. Okay, now the problem that is if it is a 100% theoretical air, but now I know that it is 150. Okay, 150 theoretical air, there is excess air 50%. So I need to add what? I need to multiply this one by 1.5 and this one also by 1.5. Okay, so this one will be 1.5 times 5 times 3.76. This will give you 28.2, and this one 1.5 times 5 is 7.5. In the previous question, we added what? We added O2. And we said we will multiply ATH by the amount added, which is 0.5. Okay, here if you did this, what it will be يعني the answer ATH is 2.5 is 5, right? And this one is 0.5. 5 times 0.5 is 2.5. But what he wrote is 2.65, not 2.5. So what is the problem here? I cannot do what I did in the whiteboard in the previous question if it is incomplete combustion process. Because why? Now, in the previous question, what I have in the products is only CO2. But here I have CO2 and also I have CO. So there is an additional amount of oxygen went to CO2. So when he said 90%, okay, at the beginning for the 100% theoretical air, it is 3 CO2, okay? If he said 90% means that CO2, so 90% of the 3, 90% of the 3 is equal to 2.7, and 10% of the 3 is equal to 0.3, this one for CO2, and this one for CO. So I have also to add 2.7 and 0.3. And I leave this one as X, yani unknown, okay? So when I want to make balance for the reaction, I will write the following. 7.5, okay, equal to 2.7 plus this one is 0.3 CO. Right, okay, so it will be if 0.3, this one is for O, so it is for O2, it will be 0.15, okay, and here I will have 4, but for O, so it is for O2, it is 2, okay. Another way, in order to يعني, خلاص, not confuse you, خلاص, let's think that it is O only, okay. Okay, only O. I'm not, I will not take O2, I will take O. Okay, so it will be like this. 7.2 times 2, okay, equal to 2.7 times 2 plus 0.3 times 1. This one is contains only 1, okay, plus 4 times 1 for H2O. Plus, here, يعني put it X, okay, and I have 2 here, so it is 2X, okay, خلاص, okay. So if I put this one in the calculator, okay, it will be 7.5 times 2 and it is equal to 2.7 times 2 plus 0.3 times 1 plus 4 times 1 plus 2 times X, shift solve, this will give you X equal to 2.65. So that is how you find the value for the excess air that we added, the free air that we added in the products, if it is incomplete process. So that is the difference between this question and the question that we solved, okay? This one, it is incomplete process. I have mass flow rate of the fuel here, and he asked also for the mass flow rate of the air. Here the temperature of the air is not the same like the reference temperature. Here he asked for the liquid, not for the gas. I need to subtract the molar mass times the enthalpy of vaporization from the enthalpy of formation. Okay, this one from table, the multiplication is from table 27, and this one from table 26, and the rest is the same. Okay, and at the end he got the answer in Q dot out and in kilowatt. Okay. So that's it. Mm, that's